We have learned that P is contained in the intersection of NP and co-NP. An important open question is whether P is actually equal to the intersection of NP and co-NP. Over the years, there have been several examples of problems that were first shown to be in NP intersect co-NP, but which then turned out to be in P. Primes is an example for this. It has been known for a long time that primes is contained in NP intersect co-NP, but only in 2002 we learned that primes is really also contained in P. Linear programming is another example, maximum flows is an example, minimum cuts are also an example. If a problem is contained in the intersection of NP and co-NP, it means that we have succinct certificates for yes instances, but also succinct disqualifiers for the no instances of the problem. And both of these can be checked efficiently. In this case, we call a problem well-characterized. Often, having a good characterization of the problem, meaning having certificates as well as disqualifiers, means we've understood something about the problem, and this often allows new insights into the problem, which eventually might lead to the discovery of a polynomial time algorithm. On the other hand, there are also notable examples that are exceptions to this, and factor is one such example. Factor is known to be in the intersection of NP and co-NP, but it's not clear whether factor is in P. In any case, since P is contained in NP intersect co-NP, to have a polynomial time algorithm for a problem, it is certainly necessary for a problem to be well characterized. The only question is whether it's sufficient for a problem to be well characterized in order for us to have a polynomial time algorithm for that problem. And this is the main open question.